Hello friends and my dear students. So I am Dr. Darwin here, and today we are going to study very important topic which is uncommonly discussed in routine ENT practice, which is nothing but superior semicircular canal dehiscence. As we all know that this important topic is also known by third window phenomena. That means it is an important cause of vestibular or auditory symptoms in both adult and children, and this is related with its etiology. I would be telling you later, but if you see this particular picture, we can appreciate a dehiscence in superior semicircular canal. So normally we have one oval window, we have one round window, but here what is happening? Here sound is leaking through third window, which is nothing but commonly in superior semicircular canal. When we come to discuss etiology about this particular thing, there are some congenital causes during development and there are acquired causes. In acquired causes, if you see, most of our patients, they correlate it with some sort of, you know, non-significant trauma. And other causes are like increased intracranial pressure, or genetics is also an important cause. So coming on to clinical picture, patient has got dizziness, that is vertigo. Patient is able to hear his own body movements, which is known as autophony. Important question in PG entrance. Patient presents to us with conductive hearing loss, which we can also see in audiometry later on. Patient has got noise induced vertigo, which is Tullio's phenomena positive. And also important thing is false positive fistula sign, which is Henneberg sign positive. And sometimes we are able to appreciate that these patients, they may have pulsatile tinnitus as that of glomus tumors. When we come to diagnosis, if we see this particular picture, this is a picture of a pure tone audiogram. Now here in these patients, we can appreciate increased airborne gap, which is hallmark of conductive hearing loss. And in contrast to this, you can see here in this particular picture that these patients, they have supranormal bone thresholds. And this is also important that we can see that in cases of autosclerosis, acoustic reflex is absent. But in these cases here, this strepidial or acoustic reflex is typically preserved. So yes, this is important that these patients have conductive hearing loss, supranormal bone thresholds. So we should be able to identify these patients by these pure tone audiograms. Coming on to next important thing, when we do radiology, when we do very thin sections, high resolution computed tomography temporal bone, somebody may ask that what view is being used to diagnose this superior semicircular canal dehiscence. It is nothing but Poschel's view. So we can see here, this is excellent mastoid pneumatization, and can we appreciate a cut in superior semicircular canal with this yellow arrow? So yes, this is superior semicircular canal dehiscence, which can also be seen in this particular view. So this is tympanomandibular joint, and here we can see this cut in superior semicircular canal or a dehiscence. So this is Poschel's view, HRCT temporal bone used for superior semicircular canal dehiscence. Coming on to treatment, when we talk about treatment, remember most of our cases of superior semicircular canal dehiscence, although this is a very, very rare entity, but yes, most of the time treatment is conservative. That means we don't go for any surgical option. So what is there in conservative management, dear students? It is avoidance of any provocative stimulus which precipitates vertigo. For example, if patient has got Tullio's phenomena, so we have to avoid those loud noise which precipitates vertigo. So yes, we can give some sedatives also, or we can avoid these stimulus. When we go for surgical options, we have numerous surgical options such as canal plugging, canal roof desurfacing and capping, or round window reinforcement. But remember, all these surgical procedures are very, very morbid procedures and take so much of time and expertise. So most of the cases, treatment is conservative, only medical management. So when we revise this superior semicircular canal dehiscence, dear students, It is third window phenomena. It is characterized by conductive hearing loss. These patients, they have increased airborne gap. These patients, they have autophony. Tullio's phenomena positive, Henneberg sign positive. Treatment most of the time is conservative and diagnosed with help of audiometry and Poschel's view CT scan. So this is all about superior semicircular canal dehiscence. Thank you very much.